Since you are watching this video, I guess your computer is running with some issue here as you are trying to open a program you have recently installed. One of these error arrived. The program can start because MSVCP100.dll is missing from your computer, or the code execution cannot proceed. MSVCR100.dll was not found. These are the exact same problem and they have the exact same solution as well. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing two problems. So let's get started. In order to download the DLL, you need to first go to Google and search for MSVCP100.dll. Choose the first result. This video is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. You can see a few download options. If you don't know your computer architecture, click on Start and search for System Information. You can see mine is a 64-bit PC, so I'll be downloading the 64-bit one. As the download complete, hit open. Inside the downloaded zip, we can see the MSVCP100.dll. Similarly, search for MSVCR100, choose the first result, download your version. Inside the downloaded zip, we can see the MSVCR100.dll. In order to move the DLL, you need to first open this PC, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder named System32. Then click on the downloaded zips, drag the MSVCP and drop, and click on continue to give administrator access. Similarly, drag the MSVCR and drop and click on continue. Finally, restart your computer. This is the summary of 32-bit process. This is only applicable if you are a 64-bit users. You need to open this PC one more time, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name syswall64. Then similarly, drag the MSVCP100.dll and drop, and click on continue. And finally, restart your computer. And similarly, drag the MSVCR/DLL and drop, and click on continue. And finally, restart your computer. This is the summary of the entire process. Every computer is different. In some special cases, download Microsoft Visual C++, distributable, choose your language and click on download, choose your Windows version, and the downloaded file will be an exe file. You can install it very easily. And that's all. If you follow me step by step, you don't have the problems left. Consider giving me support thanks if the video helps you. And follow us on our social medias and do not forget to like and subscribe. Hey, why don't you watch my other videos?